Interstate 85 in Anderson County, South Carolina, first opened to traffic around 1964. And like most of the original interstate highways built back then, concrete was the pavement of choice. Andy Johnson is South Carolina's pavement design engineer.
The original pavement for this segment was built out of concrete in the early 1960s.
In the 60s, engineers projected the concrete used in the freeways would last around 20 years. But many of these original concrete interstates lasted well beyond their expected lifespan, including Interstate 85.
The 20-year design they did for this section certainly exceeded the expectations of the original designers. We got approximately 35 years out of this pavement, even though on paper it really should have failed much earlier.
Over the years, Interstate 85 evolved into a busy route for trucking. South Carolina DOT estimates that today, 38% of the vehicles on this stretch of I-85 are heavy trucks.
A route with high truck traffic presents special challenges for pavement because trucks do the majority of the damage to pavement. Typically, a fully loaded semi will do the damage of about 15,000 automobiles.
By the mid-90s, this damage took its toll, and the original concrete, over 35 years old, required replacing.
By the 1990s, we were having quite a bit of trouble with the pavement, and we rubblized the northbound lane. However, we ran into a lot of technical difficulties with that rubblizing process.
Because of the troubles rubblizing the old concrete and replacing the northbound lanes with asphalt, when it came time to do the southbound section in July 2000, engineers chose to return to concrete.
We chose to go with an unbonded concrete overlay with an asphalt interlayer. It was decided to go with the concrete overlay in this instance because we wanted the longest lasting alternative from a user cost standpoint. We wanted to try to be off the road for as long as possible.
The southbound lanes of I-85 were widened and replaced with a 12-inch unbonded concrete overlay. Several overpasses were raised 14 inches, and the final surface was diamond ground for enhanced smoothness. Today, northbound traffic travels on asphalt while southbound drivers ride on concrete. This duality presents a unique side-by-side comparison for pavement researchers.
Asphalt pavement in general is prone to weathering, no matter how good the pavement underlying structure is, and so the surface has to be refreshed every 8 to 15 years. It depends on the conditions on the particular job. With concrete pavement, we're hoping that we can go at least 20 years before we have to go in and do any work, but we would expect at least another 10 to 15 years out of this pavement without any work, and it's 10 years old now.
Concrete is known for its durability and long life. That's why South Carolina DOT is using concrete more frequently for road projects, including work currently underway on Interstate 385 in Lawrence County.
Concrete pavement is being used more and more frequently in South Carolina. The economics of concrete pavement right at this time are outstanding. When you're talking about surface life, concrete probably has an edge.
Johnson says patching the aging asphalt along I-385 was costing the state over $1 million a year. This rehab project will bring 385 up to interstate standards and will feature a new 10-inch jointed plain concrete pavement.
At the moment, concrete pavement is actually, for high-volume roads, our most economical choice.
Back in Anderson County, drivers are traveling south on 10-year-old concrete that's expected to provide a smooth surface for another 15 years or more.
We're very proud of the ride that we achieved on the concrete on this section of I-85 here in Anderson County. And the advantage, of course, with concrete is we hope it will maintain that ride for decades to come.
For the Road to Success, I'm Doug Barron.